हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अवर टुडे लेक्चर। इन अवर टुडे लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म अवर फर्स्ट टेस्ट एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू चेक दैट हाउ कैन वी से दैट देर इज स्टेशनरी और नॉन स्टेशनरी सीरीज इन अवर डाटा। सो बेसिकली वी आर गोइंग टू चेक द स्टेशनरी ऑफ अवर डाटा सेट। सो दैट इज़ अवर टुडे टॉपिक एंड वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई ऑगमेंटेड डिग्रीफुलर टेस्ट in order to check the stationarity of the data set. So for that we have to bring our data from Excel to Stata file. So I am going with the short option. I am going to copy my all data which I am interested to see either that is stationary or non-stationary. So as I have already copied my data, now I am going to data editor. So here I have to simply paste my data. I have to go with this option that treat first row as variable name. So my data is here in Stata file. Now I have to go to statistic, then go to time series statistics, then go to test, and here you can see that here is the option for augmented Digi-Fuller test. So apply this test. So here it is asking about you variable name. So let's say I am going to check the stationery of this variable, which is LNG. So I am going with this option LNG. So here it is asking about display regression table, include drift term, which is mean intercept, trend, and here it mean constant term in regression. Suppressed mean that do not take constant term or only take constant term in data set. So we will discuss all of these things later on in our lecture, that what is intercept and what is mean trend and trend and intercept. So for today lecture we are only interested to check the issue of stationary. So we are keeping it as simple as possible. So as we have selected our variable name here from which variable we are interested to check the stationary, and from time setting we have to set time variable here which is in year, and from this option we have to select that either our data is quarterly, daily, weekly, monthly. As my data set is yearly, so I am going with this option yearly. So now I have to click on OK. Then again click on OK. So here you can see that we have the results or outcome for the augmented Digi-Fuller test. So for now we have to compare this t value with this 5% value. Okay, so we have to compare this test statistic value with this critical value at 5%, and keep in mind we have to take values in absolute term. We have to ignore this minus sign here, and as it is already in positive, but if it is negative then we also have to ignore this negative sign here as well. So what is the guideline? The guideline is that we have two hypotheses. One is called null hypothesis and the other one is called alternative hypothesis. So the null hypothesis is that data is not stationary, and the alternative hypothesis is that H1 is data is stationary. So if this value is less than this value in absolute term, so then we have to accept the null hypothesis, which means that data is not stationary. But in this case our test set value is less than this value, so we have to accept the null hypothesis, which means that data is not stationary. I am repeating it again that for the exception or for the rejection we have to compare test statistic with the p value, critical value of 5% in absolute term. If टेस्ट स्टैट इज लेस देन 5% क्रिटिकल वैल्यू, वी हैव टू एक्सेप्ट द नल हाइपोथेसिस. इन दिस केस आवर टी स्टैट इज 0.442 एंड आवर क्रिटिकल वैल्यू ऑफ 5% इज 3. As keep in mind, I have mentioned that we have to take an absolute term. So, we have to accept the null hypothesis, which means that our data is not stationary. So, this is the guideline for checking the stationary. If test stat is less than the critical value of 5%, then you have to accept the null hypothesis. And what is null hypothesis? Data is not stationary. And if it is greater than this value, you have to reject the null hypothesis, meaning that your data is stationary. So that's all for today's lecture. This is how you can check the stationary of any data set.